So next, let's move on to the annotation tab. So in here, you have all the annotations Paperscan provides. These options are only usable with Paperscan Pro. So in the Home Edition and Free Edition, you will only be able to see these options, but not be able to use them. So first off, the highlighter and the freehand highlighter. So this allows you to highlight a selection of your page. The freehand highlighter allows you to draw on the page, allowing you to highlight things on the page. Now, these have properties which you can modify, as shown here. If I want the highlighted selection to be in red, simply click red, and same for this one. These annotation properties vary depending on the annotation you pick. So that's it for the highlighter and the freehand highlighter. Next, you have all shapes and forms you can choose from, as rectangle, ellipse, polygon, freehand polygon, and so on. Then you have lines, connected lines, arrows, freehand pen. You can also choose to import an image. For importing images, simply click on image, then select the image you want to import onto your page. Then, once you have selected which one you want to import, draw by clicking and dragging onto your page, and then you can choose where you want to place it on your page. And if you want to delete it, simply click delete. You also have rubber stamp, text, sticky note, ruler, polygon ruler, and so on. These last three options, I will explain them more into detail compared to these options, which are minor. So the preset annotation editor uses all these annotations here, but saves them so you don't have to keep creating them to apply them to different pages. So I will make one as shown here. Simply click on new preset name. I will create stamp date, which will be my date, which I will apply to all pages. Then create the rubber stamp. Simply draw the rubber stamp wherever you want to apply it on your page, as shown here. I want to apply it to the bottom left, like so. Then draw on, I want to select which pages I want to draw it on. If I only want to draw it on this page that I have previewed, on even page numbers, on odd page numbers, or on all pages. I want to apply it to all pages, simply click that, and it's done. Then you want to select the properties of your annotation. I'm going to select transparent for the contour. Then for the text, I'm going to select black. And that is all. Then I will need to edit the text for my stamp. However, if I select the date in here, it will not update with my older text if I want to apply this at a future date. So instead of modifying this text here, I can use the advanced option override text with custom value here and select date in here. Simply click insert, and this will automatically detect the date at which you're applying this annotation on. So as today is the 31st of October, it automatically detected the date of today. Simply click save once you are done. Make sure all the settings that you want you have picked, and once you're done, click save. Now your annotation has been made, click close, and to apply your annotation to all the pages, click preset annotations and the title of the annotations you've just made. And as you can see here, it's applied my date to this page, to this one, and to the last one, as shown here. Now, one of the most important features, of course, is burn annotations. If you do not do this, this will not embed your annotation onto the page. So make sure you select this, or otherwise your annotation won't be saved properly. So that is all you need to know about the annotations.